To be considered a serial killer, you gotta do two things. You gotta kill more than three people, and you gotta do it in a time period of over a month. These people on the list blow that out of the water.
Top six!
Most dangerous people in the world. These are murderers who did all the killing themselves and are still alive today.
Number six.
Robert Charles Brown. This killer actually believed he was doing some sort of service to society. He's quoted as saying,
"Women are unfaithful. They screw around a lot. They cheat. They are not of the highest moral value."
And who is of the highest moral value, Mr. Brown? You?
I don't know. Oprah, maybe? Shut up, bitch.
He traveled across America for 25 years, killing random women he met in 9 states. In his confession, Robert Charles Brown admitted to killing 49 people. The sicko was arrested in 1995, thank God, and charged with 2 life sentences. Excuse me, I feel like it should be 49 life sentences.
Number 5.
Alexander Pashishkin, the chessboard killer. This crazy Russian once said,
"Life without murder is like life without food."
Except without food, we die. And with murder, we die. But good logic.
Why, thank you. I'll kill you last.
He wanted to kill 64 people, the same number of squares on a chessboard. I just want to state for the record that if I were the person in charge of creating catchy serial killer names, I wouldn't have given him the one that he wanted. I would have called him something like, I don't know, the Connect Four Crazy, the Monopoly Mangler. What's the lamest game ever? The Tic-Tac-Toe Tapper. I don't fucking know. Pashishkin would find old homeless men, share vodka with them, and then hit them over the head with a hammer. To finish them off, he shoved the vodka bottle in their skulls. You know, as if the hammer thing wasn't enough. When he wasn't doing that, sometimes he would just kill people in the park. He'd sneak up behind them and whack them with a hammer. He killed 60 people before he was caught. And during his trial in 2007, he was held in a glass box, like a fire hose. He got life in prison with the first 15 years solitary confinement. My favorite part? He didn't reach his goal.
Number 4.
Donald Harvey, the angel of death. When he was 18 years old, Donald Harvey began working as an orderly at Marymount Hospital in Kentucky. In his first 10 months working there, he killed 12 patients. No, guys, it's okay. He said he just wanted to put them out of their misery. Okay, so I guess his empathy defense explains why he put poison in their food, injections, IVs, the times he suffocated them, turned off their ventilators, injected them with HIV. By the time they figured out that these deaths weren't just random coincidences, he had murdered 87 people. Harvey is currently serving 8 consecutive life sentences in Ohio. 8? Shouldn't it be 87? I don't get this math.
Number 3.
Maria de Jesus Gonzalez. Las Puyantes. Yay, a lady made the list of murderers. In the 1960s, Maria and her sister Delfina owned this Mexican brothel known as the Bordello from Hell. The sisters would put out ads for maids or waitresses. But when they got there, they were forced to be prostitutes in a brothel that was more like a concentration camp. And if a girl got too sick to work because of an STD or a botched abortion, they were locked in a room and starved to death. The sisters also killed customers that showed up with a lot of money. When the police finally raided the brothel, they found a couple of buried fetuses alongside 11 men and 80 women. The sisters were given 40 years in jail. Delfina died in prison, but Maria finished her sentence and was released. What? She's out now? Just living? How is that possible?
Number 2.
Pedro Rodriguez Filho, Killer Petey. This Brazilian killer started young. When he was 14, his dad was fired for allegedly stealing food. So he did what any kid would do. He murdered his father's boss. His friend was killed in a gang, so he killed 10 people from the gang. And all this killing happened before he was 18. He was arrested in 1973, where he met up with his father in prison. You see, his father was there for killing Pedro's mother with a machete. So to avenge his mother's death, he killed his father, cut out his heart, and chewed it before he chucked it. Everything made sense until the chewing part. He went on to kill 47 more, all while he was in jail. Don't want to be an inmate in that prison. He later confessed to 100 victims. Pedro was sentenced to 400 years in prison. Finally, that sounds about right. But he only served 34, and then he was released. Come on!
And number 1.
Pedro Lopez, the monster of the Andes. Can't do that. His target was young girls between 9 and 12 years old. By the time he was 30, he had raped and strangled over 100 girls in Colombia. Then he almost got caught, so he moved to Ecuador. He said,
"I like the girls in Ecuador. They are more gentle and trusting, more innocent."
I like want to punch something right now. That's so fucked up. After Ecuador, he went on to kill people in Peru. Don't worry, he was caught, thank God. In 1983, he confessed to 350 murders. He was declared insane, clearly, and served 14 years in a psychiatric hospital. Yeah, and this is where we start worrying again. Lopez was released in 1998 on good behavior after serving only 14 years. Yes, that's 2 weeks per victim. Can I punch something now? Can I punch something now? Yeah, so right now this monster is 66 years old and just free to roam the Andes as he pleases. Yeah, so I'd cancel that South American hiking vacay if I were you.
Top six!
I'm Kelly Landry, and you're smarter and more terrified than you were. The most dangerous people. These are murderers who committed their own murders. That sounds funny, like they killed themselves.
AKA the just mod killer. Yeah, the sludgy beaches. Leaf with a murder.
Yeah, that was good.
That's Russian, yeah. Right?
Okay. Fucking pussy Russian. Pussy Russian bitch. Please don't kill me.
I don't know. Oprah, maybe? Shut up, bitch.
Oprah.
Yes, sir.